Well, this workout is going to be a great hip toner and buttock toner. The reason why is because you're using the wall, and with your back on the ground, you're really having to use that force of the wall to realign your hip. So if you have any hip issues or your body, your hip to misalign, using the wall will help you to reestablish that and put your body in that great perfect posture. So Mary Arlene will walk her feet down a little bit. And she'll raise her hips up and bring her body a little bit more forward to the wall, will allow you to stack your knees above your shoulders. And so now she's being able to push off with her toes, and she's bringing that the hips forward and allowing those muscles in her glutes to begin to squeeze right into the sacrum, right where the attachments are at, all along the sacrum. And that's that tailbone area. Right in the back, that bone right in the back of your buttock, and being able to push it forward by squeezing your buttock will really help to stabilize your hips. From there, holding that position a little bit, you can begin to have your bring your legs closer together, and we'll do a nice little routine here, kind of working in different phases. You might find this is hard enough and you can't do any more, and that's fine. Otherwise, we can add to this variation by taking your right foot up in the air, and she's still pushing off with her left foot. From there, she's going to bring her leg all the way down and then lift up her left foot. There you go. Keep that up there, and then go ahead and bring that foot all the way down and go right into your plow. So she's got herself in a beautiful plow position, and having her hands on the wall is fine, or having her hands on the floor. But as you can see, this is a good deep stretch deep into her hips and really good into her legs. Holding that for a moment, she'll inhale. And you can just stay there for a little bit. Of plow is a great way to loosen up your spine and begin to break up the tension in your shoulders and your neck. So if you have a lot of neck and shoulder tension, this is a great exercise and being able to break that all up. From there, she's going to begin to raise up her right leg. Take it all the way up. Good. Nice and strong. And then she's going to put that foot back on the wall. She's going to lift up her left leg and point it up to the ceiling. And while she's doing that, she's bringing her hips forward. She's going to squeeze again deep down inside of her buttock and into the sacral area and pushing those hips forward evenly, creating that stacking sensation. Good. And then she'll put that foot back on the wall. So, beautiful stretch here for her legs, opening up into the hip joint and ball in the socket area, cleaning that all up, making it real nice and centered and balanced. Then she's going to walk her feet down a little bit. And this is another phase that we're going into. If you find that you need your fatigue, come down, take a break, and come back up. From that, she will have her feet on the wall. I'm going to have her separate her feet a little bit more, and this is going to be a really nice deep contraction into her buttock area. With her feet being on the balls of her feet on the wall, she's going to go ahead and lower her hips down a little. See if you can bring them both together at the same time, and you exhale when you're coming up. Two more times like that. Real nice and tight and squeeze. Good. And one more time. And perfect. And what you're going to do is it goes so deep down to the lower part of your buttock and really tones that up, along with toning up her hamstrings and her gastroc, all of that. It's really a beautiful leg and hip toner.